Meyer?
Yes.
You're there, right?
I'm here.
I'm here.
But it's like you're gathering.
No.
Everybody is here.
Oh.
Because everybody's.
But you're.
My house is fine, yeah. We didn't, we're on the other side of the.
No. Yeah, maybe. Okay, we do have our forum here.
Sorry.
And I am calling the meeting to order at, well, my clock says 11. So, here we are. And the agenda is on the screen here, as you can see. We need to approve the board minutes. And so if you take a look at those.
Motion to approve, I've read them.
All right, anybody else need a little bit more time to take a look at the minutes? All right. We have a motion to approve, so when you're done, you can, one of you can say it.
I'll second.
Any discussion or questions? Hearing none, call for the vote. All those in favor of approving the minutes as printed here, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed?
No.
Okay, the minutes are passed. Okay, time for public comments. Okay, I don't see anyone here that's ready to do public comments. So I think we'll move along. Okay. Okay.
Madam President, there are zero speaker cards for the minutes. Public comment, there are zero public comment speaker cards.
Okay. Thank you. Okay, and CEO's report?
For the CEO's report, we have a student presentation and our new staff member introduction. We currently do not have any new staff members to introduce. For our student presentation, we have our high school students.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Sorry to interrupt. We want to make sure we were on public comments.
I'm happy to reopen public comments.
Thank you.
For a limited amount of time because we need to move through the agenda.
Don't worry. I appreciate it.
Okay, we have.
We have plenty of.
Actually, what I need to do is I need to pull the rest of the board. Are you willing to open for public comments?
Just the one speaker, as far as I'm concerned. I mean, people just have to be here on time. I race to get here on time.
I'm sorry. We wait plenty of time for all of you. There's plenty of executive board members or board members who show up late all the time. I've been witness to it myself. You're extending the courtesy to each of your board members. It should be extended to the community as well.
Okay, one speaker?
No,
yes.
It's not one speaker. We have plenty of speakers.
Is what we will accept at this point?
I think you need to accept everyone here who is wanting to speak to the board with regards to the decisions that have taken place.
Look, we called it, there were no cards, no one's here. We always start, if I'm late, you start. You call.
You're more than welcome to fill in the gallery and to listen to the meeting. At this point, there is an objection to more than one speaker, and so I'm going to ask the board, do we allow one speaker? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay.
I would like to...
Are you the public speaker?
I would like to ask the board to open public comments to more than one speaker. We have a contingent of community members who want to speak to you. And I think it's poor form on your part that you're denying people their ability to speak when you've extended the same courtesy to each and every one of us.
People can't speak out.
I've seen it.
You may take a seat in the gallery.
And I would really urge you to reconsider.
Absolutely. I'd like to ask the board if you'd like to take a quick recess. Okay. We're out for recess.
So we're meeting recess at 10:05.
Yep.
Living in the Hispanic black community. I'm going to start
Lo que está pasando es que ellos dicen, oh, a pesar de que llegamos a las 10:02 y aquí la entrada de ellos los restringió y impidió que nosotros pudiéramos entrar aquí a tiempo, lo que sucede ahorita, están tomando ventaja de eso, de esas trabas que ellos están haciendo, y ahora diciendo de que como llegaron tarde, ustedes no tienen el derecho de hablar. ¿Qué le parece eso a ustedes?
No es justo porque nos cerraron las puertas y no nos dejaron entrar.
Exactamente. Y ahorita lo que la cortesía que ellos están extendiéndonos es de que solo una persona van a dejar hablar. ¿Lo cree?
En eventos públicos se puede restringir la voz del pueblo.
¿Qué les parece eso?
Somos comunidad y tenemos derecho a hablar.
En cualquier escuela tenemos el derecho como padres de esa comunidad.
Así es.
Conocemos nuestros derechos. Todos tenemos el mismo derecho de hablar y de exponer nuestras preocupaciones y lo que no es justo. Claro que así debe de ser.
Y ahorita, eso es lo que ahorita están tomando ventaja.
No
los quieren no permitir hablar. Y lo que ahorita por lo menos están haciendo, ellos están suspendiendo la reunión por unos minutos para que platiquen y a ver si los van a extender la cortesía.
¿Cuál cortesía? Es un derecho.
¿Verdad?
Es un derecho y es justicia para el pueblo.
No tienen respeto hacia la comunidad. Esa falta de respeto hacia nosotros como comunidad. ¿Cuál es el respeto que tienen con la comunidad?
Así es.
Porque es el primero, solamente el money.
Well, you know what? You shouldn't have a board meeting during school hours in this situation.
Understood, but unfortunately, instructions happen right now. We'd like to just be able to keep.
Well, this is public comment, and we have a right to be speaking.
Absolutely.
Ellos cambian las reglas al último momento para tratar de callarnos la voz y no está bien. Ha sido suficiente años de estar cometiendo este tipo de fraude con nuestra gente.
Entonces que nos junten el tiempo de todos para una sola persona. ¿Les parece eso justo?
Ni siquiera viven en esta comunidad, no saben lo que necesitamos en esta comunidad y tienen el descaro de tratar de callarnos la voz.
No. Y como ven, muchos padres ahora no quieren que hablemos, pero no vienen padres. Ay, sí, nos dan 2 minutos nada más.
¿Verdad?
Yeah, why?
It's very hard to hear the truth.
Entonces nosotros vamos a decirles que así como nos dan 4 minutos, solo una persona quiere que hablemos. No, nosotros les vamos a exigir que una persona en 4 minutos nos resuelvan los problemas de todos.
Yeah,
va a ser lo mismo. Ustedes respetan sus ideas, nosotros también vamos a respetar.
Igualdad
para todos.
They're coming to our community and press our voice. You operate with public funds. If it wasn't for the children in this community, the accelerated schools would not exist. This is not the model of the accelerated school. This is not sitting at the table and making shared decision making and hearing people's voice. Didn't someone just send out something about feedback, an email to staff about feedback? Why don't you want to take our feedback?
Hay pruebas desde cuanto nos vieron. El security nos vio, cerró la puerta y desapareció de ahí. Ahorita fue y abrió la puerta y es tarde. Entonces, hay pruebas, hay pruebas.
Muchas dudas por qué corrieron a Hilda, que es la única que nos ayudaba. Pero dicen que nosotros como padres pedimos que la corrieran, cuando es mentira.
Yo lo único que quiero saber es por qué esa discriminación contra nosotros, contra nuestra comunidad.
Okay, we are reconvening at 10:11.
Si es tarde, ¿por qué toda la gente está llegando tarde? Toda la gente está llegando tarde, los de ellos.
I'm going to read you what's on the agenda.
No vinimos a interrumpir nada, ni siquiera me empezamos.
Individuals wishing to speak at any board meeting must sign up at the meeting. There will be no sign-ups in advance of the meeting. Each speaker is to keep his or her public comments to a maximum of 2 minutes to state his or her issue clearly. The Accelerated Schools board meetings are held on school grounds during times when school is in session. Members of the public are welcome to meetings, but must remember not to be disruptive on school grounds. This includes keeping any public comments at a volume level in consideration of class instruction going on nearby. What the board has decided is that we will reopen public comments for 15 minutes. If you wish to think about who you would like to speak for you, in case all of you cannot speak within the 15 minutes we're allowing during this reopening of public comments, you may take a moment to determine who would be the speaker. Yes. And if you are speaking, you do need to fill in the speaker cards. This is a practice that LAUSD supports and requires for any speakers at their board meetings, and we are following their policy as well. So we'll give you...
Well, just to be clear, I would like to let you know that your barriers right here are things that obstruct people's ingress into these board meetings, and I think that even these 15 minutes are not enough. Okay, we'll take them up because we're that eager to speak to you with regards to what is occurring here. But we're letting you know that it's not okay. You essentially created barriers that had us be late by a couple minutes when. Every single person here on this board, not every single person,
but I've been here long enough. Do you want your comments to be a part of the 15 minutes?
No.
Okay, then you need to allow these people to determine who's going to speak.
No, it's not going to work that way. They're going to sign up.
Yes, it is
going to
work.
You're a racist!
They're going to sign up.
In a black and Hispanic community, and you white people take advantage. I taught here for 50 years. And the children need to be heard.
Okay, we have reopened for public comments. I would hope that we would not have to close that because of disrupted people. Do you have speakers that are ready to speak?
Yeah, but you have a pen, so we have to write it down.
have to turn in a legal card.
We will commence the reopening of public comments for 15 minutes, starting now. So, who is your first speaker? Ms. Diaz?
Okay. Estoy aquí por la razón de que
I'm here for the reason that
hace unos días puse una queja porque la maestra Alpania ha llamado burros a sus alumnos, incluyendo a mi hijo.
A couple days, a teacher of my student called our colleague kids dog.
Estoy molesta por eso.
My child.
Y mi hijo está pagando las consecuencias de eso porque ya ha quitado las clases de español.
And my child is paying the consequences of that. He's been denied a Spanish class.
La maestra Fania sigue trabajando como si nada. Ahora mi hijo está sin clases de español. Quiero saber la razón por qué mi hijo está sin las clases de español. ¿Quién le va a enseñar el español a escribir, a leer? Yo, las matemáticas también que me mandan a la casa, yo se las tengo que enseñar.
The teacher Tanya, she's fine and well, and my child is no longer in Spanish classes. Who's going to be teaching my child Spanish classes?
A la maestra admitir que sí le dijo burro, okay. Yo pedí que me lo cambiaran de salón, pero que me le pongan clases de español. Si él no tiene clases de español, ¿a qué lo mando a la escuela?
When she admitted what she said, they moved my kid from the classroom. Oh, what help does that do with my child?
¿Dónde quedan los derechos de mi hijo?
Where are my child's rights at?
Esa es una. La segunda es, quiero saber por qué corrieron a Hilda. ¿Por qué nos culpan como padres de que pedimos que la corrieran cuando nosotros queremos a Hilda de
now,
vuelta en el trabajo?
Now, my second issue is with regards to Hilda's termination. How is it that y'all are planning to speak on behalf of parents that we wanted that her position eliminated when that's far from the case? Us as parents admire Hilda and want her at task.
Y la tercera es, queremos buena comida para nuestros hijos en la escuela.
And third, we want good food for our child here at school.
Porque todos los días, a las 12 del día, están tomando leche con un pedazo de pan,
because
un pedazo de pizza.
Every day they're just drinking milk. At lunchtime they're drinking milk with a piece of bread, with some pizza.
Esa es la alimentación que tiene mi hijo. Mi hijo ya tuvo anemia una vez.
That's the kind of nutrition that is served here. My child has already had anemia once.
Yo me veo cansada de todos los días tener que traerle comida porque la escuela según no tiene fondos para darles de comer bien.
I'm tired of having to always send my child with food because the school claims that they don't have the resources to be able to fund these kinds of programs.
Queremos respuestas para todas las dudas que tenemos, todos los problemas que hay.
We want answers.
Aquí es donde tenemos que poner quejas y ustedes ya no nos querían dejar hablar.
Here is where we come and speak with regards to our concerns, and you're not going to let us all speak. What is that about?
Nosotros como padres o nos quieren callar la voz porque tenemos voz y creo que ya estamos despertando porque como ven ya hay más padres aquí que están hablando. Antes no había padres. No se les avisa a uno de padres que va a junta de la mesa directiva.
Are you willfully trying to skirt around our parents' input? Because that's something that has existed in the past, and as you can tell, we're waking up as parents. We're not just sitting idle anymore.
Para el café con la directora hay una llamada, una operadora que llama cada martes para recordar el café con la directora. ¿Por qué no se llama para la junta de la mesa directiva que es muy importante para exigir los derechos de nuestros hijos?
Oh, you have plenty of robocalls with regards to all kinds of other dubious matters. Why is it that you don't make the robocalls reminding parents about these meetings, with these board meetings?
Estamos cansados. Y ya no vamos a permitir que
se violen
los derechos de nuestros hijos.
We're tired and we're not going to let the rights of our child and as parents to be tread upon.
No crean que porque somos latinos vamos a
sentirnos intimidados y
vamos a callar. Ya se terminó ese tiempo y creo que ya vamos a empezar a exigir los derechos de nuestros hijos y de nosotros como padres también.
Those days are over. And we are going to begin to demand more for our children as parents.
Thank you very much for your comments.
Hello.
Martha Sanchez.
Good morning, My name is Martha Sanchez. I'm a member of ACE, but I'm also a member of the San Francisco Neighborhood Council. When this school was proposed to be built in this school, the Neighborhood Council opposed to build a new building because we were aware of the very bad things that were happening in the old building. We were really concerned about the inclusion, about the respect, about all the things that the parents have been complaining already. And now that Hilda has been laid out, we are extremely upset of the many processes that are taking place. We are extremely concerned about our children. I have nieces and nephews coming to this school site, and I'm very concerned about their education because this building was built with the promise of serving a disadvantaged community. And it is not taking place. It's not happening. I'm extremely concerned of the many things that are happening every single day. We visit door by door families that tell stories about the many processes that are not taking place. We want to demand, we are not asking, we want to demand the reinstatement of Hilda Rodriguez because she is truly loved in this community. She has been named as the hero in this community. Everyone in this community knows the legacy of Hilda. She belongs to the community. She lives in the community. She's part of the community. She's not only advocating for resources for schools, she's advocating for resources for that whole community. So it is really disappointing. It's really an insult for our community, for our members. I live just few blocks away from here on 30th Street, and I always walk this way to see how many kids came to this school that don't belong to the community, that don't live in this community, and they don't understand the struggles that we face every single day. So, again, we are here to demand the reinstatement of Hilda Solis. Hilda Solis, she's the senator right now.
Stephanie, I'm sorry, I cannot read the last name.
Good morning, my name is Stephanie Guzman. I am a TAG alumni. I'm here today to express my disappointment in this board's decision to wrongfully terminate my mother from her position that she has held since I was in elementary school at TAG. My mother has been instrumental in advocating for me as a student with disabilities, as many other students throughout the years. Unfortunately, she had to fight TAS hard to get me the much needed services and support. Because of my mother's advocacy, I was able to attend and graduate from college this spring with a Bachelor's of Science in Speech and Language Pathology from the University of the Pacific. It's discouraging that TAS hasn't been inconsistent. That TAS hasn't been inconsistent with its mission and vision to give students a quality education that it promised. Instead, board and management has instilled fear in parents, staff, and educators that speak up for students like me. The high turnover of teachers and staff negatively impacted my education. I went years without credentialed teachers in core subjects like math and English. Stability is crucial for students living in this community. My mother, Hilda, is an exponential role model and dedicated, compassionate, caring, hardworking employee, an activist within our community and at large. I'm asking the board to reconsider its retaliatory action toward my mother and reinstate her position.
Thank you for your comments. By the way, congratulations on your new brief. Jorge Roman.
Good morning, folks. Hope all is well. It's been a while. I actually wrote a letter for the office this time. I would like to remind every single one of you of something very important, that perhaps the cacophony of sycophants around you may not be articulating. The decision to terminate Hilda by the TAS administration was because of her union and parent activism as a stakeholder in this school, or these schools, now that there's three. Firing someone for union activities is a violation of not only state law, but in today's Union Blue California, this action is the most villainous trope an employer could have engaged in. Right before a historic election year, and in a political climate that is holding charter schools' feet to the fire. The decision to terminate Lida was done in your name as the board, and every one of you is exposed, and this exposure will only grow. With your new investment initiatives, you have better use of your time, and you need to resolve this matter as much as for yourself as for Lida. I urge you to reevaluate your management's decisions, have them put their differences with Lida aside, and re-employ her. There are open positions available. You should do it. It's the right thing to do. There's exit ramps available. You should take them. Thank you.
Thank you for your comments. Justin.
My name is Justin Guzman. I'm Hilda's youngest child and former student at Accelerated Schools. I will share the following statements that were posted online about my mother. This board needs to know that she has developed a deep connection with the community and she has helped countless people, which include students, staff, and parents alike. This comment is from Isamar Ponce, former TAS student. I attended TAS from kindergarten to the beginning of 11th grade, and Hilda was a calming and supportive presence in the school. I often felt other staff and admin made places of the school feel uncomfortable. Holds always provided an environment for us students to feel calm, especially as a school nurse. It is true that kids can sometimes feel physical symptoms from anxiety created by other defaults of the school. I can positively say my time at the school was less than ideal, but Hilda is one of the few good memories and people who I can say positively impacted my school life. I'm in my third year at UCLA right now, and when I have a big test coming up or some sort of something of that sort, I can remember having that same feeling the first or third or even ninth grade, and I know that this time it will be okay. I can only hope to someday have such a wonderful impact on any school, community, and large number of students, as I know Hilda was for me and my three siblings. Thank you.
I believe we have time for one more speaker, and that would be Joe Stringer.
Good morning to the board. I'd just like to say one thing before I get started. This reminds me of 1953. I was down in the deep south and was carried to a kangaroo court. This is what this reminds me of, that kangaroo court. I thought we had got rid of the kangaroo court, but I see we haven't. One day, kangaroo court will not exist any longer. I want all of you board members to get that in your mind. And I'm looking at this board. I don't see no parents over here that say they got some kids around in here, or anybody that got some family members on the board. I don't see nobody look like them. Where are they at? I would like to know, where are they? I think this community would like to know, where are they? This community would like to know, where are they? Just like you were sitting at that board, they want some of their community, some of their family people sitting there too. Why not? No justice. They want justice. And they ain't going to get it with you sitting there. I want you to take that home and sleep on it. I want you to do that. Think about it. Think about what you're looking for, what you want to do. You sit here and talk that talk. We want to do for the kids. We want to do this and that. You want to do for the kids? Let the kids see a mixed board. Let them see a mixed board. That'll do something for Better give them hope. Better give them courage. I could stand here and talk all day, but I'm going to stop.
Thank you very much for your comment.
Justice for Hilda!
Justicia para Hilda!
Okay, that will close public comments for today.
There's three more people who want to speak.
I'll keep their cards.
No. There are three more people who want to speak.
Excuse me,
She is a parent of, she's a parent of Taz.
And I am the president of the board, and we have reopened public comments for 15 minutes and given you the opportunity. Public comments are now closed.
So we're urging you to open them again. It's three more people that want to speak.
No, I have another people, and we don't have time to do that.
We don't even have the moderator. Again, just so you know, okay, we should not be counting. We should not be counting the 4 minutes of Spanish speakers in that. Okay?
I would like to ask the board if you would like another recess.
As a matter of fact, we still have Hilda who hasn't spoken. She wants to speak to the board.
Excuse me. Good morning. My name is Hilda. I'm founding South Parent Brown, mother of ACES student, health service coordinator from 2007 to 2019. Taz ACS local 99 chief steward at large. And former Taz
Walker.
Shame on you! Shame on you!
And its management retaliatory decision to abruptly terminate my employment via email on July 11th from the accelerated schools. These past few months have been extremely difficult, especially after I read an investigation report regarding a complaint that I had filed in 2016 in which I was unknowingly and falsely accused of a tragedy that concerned a minor student at the time. It's utterly disgusting! Disgusting! I have always taken all of my roles and responsibilities to heart and prided myself in helping students, parents, staff, administration, management, and community to the best of my ability. I have volunteered countless hours of my personal time since 1994 for the betterment of the accelerated schools and community. One of the principal aspects of the accelerated schools model is to institute a governance structure characterized by board, staff, and parent participation in decision making and by procedures for taking stock of the school's strengths and problems and for generating solutions. Sadly, we have veered from some of the core foundational principles of the accelerated schools model, in which Taz was established in 1994 in our community. I strongly believe, but I don't know after today, honestly, that if we work together to reestablish the core principle of the shared decision making and genuinely take stock by recognizing our strengths and weaknesses and by collaboratively developing solutions, we can make positive impacts on our entire community. No school system is perfect, but if we work with fidelity, integrity, accountability, and transparency, anything is possible. My job at Taz never ended after my shift was over. Even now, after my wrongful termination, Taz has been a part of my life for over 25 years. And it's heartbreaking to experience and witness firsthand the demise of its core foundational principles. I have done nothing wrong but cared and advocated for students, parents, staff, and community. I do not deserve this unjust treatment by this board, administration, and management. There has been an outpouring of support on my behalf that has been truly heartwarming and a true testament to what I mean for so many and what I stand for today. In closing, I ask this board to reconsider its erroneous and retaliatory decision and reinstate me in my position as health service coordinator, effective immediately. It's very sad that these chairs are empty from these board members. They're huddling in the back, hiding from the public. It's disgusting. It's shameful. There is no words. This is not what this was supposed to be.
¡Que queremos!
¡Justicia!
¡Queremos!
meeting and dismiss the board.
Why don't you dismiss this school committee meeting right now?
Dismiss yourself out of line!
Why don't you dismiss this school committee meeting right now?
Just so folks know, they do not want to open public sessions and hear the public. They're using dubious grounds as to why the public session, the public comment part was cut short to silence the community. And let that be known.
The public comment session was not cut short. It was reopened to accommodate those of you who could speak within 15 minutes. Therefore, if there are any more outbreaks, we will close the board session and we will adjourn.
We urge you to reopen the public session, the public comment session.
I have already ruled on that, and okay, that will not happen today.
We urge you to open the public session once again. We have people from the public who want to speak. You're denying people their right to be heard.
We are following the protocol, and as I have said, if there are any more outbreaks, and that includes from you, sir, we will adjourn the board meeting.
The problem is that you're not used to. You're not used to these voices. You always have a board member
who is typically me. Also,
it's typically you that is speaking on the behalf, because you have these board meetings during the hours of instruction when our staff, when our teachers, when our parents are unable to attend. You cannot continue. This is not the accelerated school model. This is not shared decision making.
Que pararnos, compañeros, que pararnos. Ellos ahorita ya están cancelando la junta. ¿Qué les parece eso?
¡Hoy queremos la comunidad!
¿Y cuándo? ¿Qué queremos?
If we can't get it,
shut it down.
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 If this board refuses to listen to the voices of this community, we will shut you down.
Forever and ever, shut you down.
Que ser una fila. United will never be divided. The people 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 united will never be divided. The people.
Vámonos. ¿Qué salir?
¿Qué seguirnos?
No, it's fine.
No,
they can't do that.
No, don't worry about that. That's false imprisonment. They can't do that.
This is not a prison, this is not a jail, this is a place where he can get home.
Puro fraude.
Como debieron de los pueblos. Familia, presidenta, y cuando yo les llamaba, yo que luego iba a Alemania, yo les llamaba.
Sí. No tenía que haberme negado el derecho a hablar porque yo soy padre de esta comunidad. Sí.
¿Sé que tengo una denuncia? ¿De quién es eso?
Oh, son de los... Son de
ellos,
los
creo, de los...
Esa es la seguridad que deberían tener diario. Diario deberían de traer esta seguridad.
Eso es lo que yo creo que me cuando me metieron el dinero para acá, porque me llamó a la policía. Ay, calladito,
si ellos quisieran calmar las cosas, deberían de regresar y hablar como la gente.
Firmamos como visitantes de la escuela y aquí estamos sin hacer problemas.
Si
necesitan, deben
llamar
a la policía, llamen nos
comida a todos. Ya. Ellos saben ya la cocinada que tienen en la escuela.
Ok, vamos a mantener el espíritu bajo para que haya paz. Queremos, si van a salir los niños, no queremos que nos vean que estamos cautivos o que estamos de alguna manera vigilados. También se van a preguntar, ¿qué está la policía ahí con nuestros padres, verdad? No queremos que que piensen que está pasando algo grave, porque el simple hecho de vernos aquí rodeados como en una jaula hace pensar mal, ¿verdad? Hasta el niño más pequeño va a preguntar, ¿por qué están esos señores ahí encerrados? ¿Por qué está la policía ahí encerrándonos?
Ya se fueron para otro salón, para otra oficina.
¿Cuándo van a venir?
No, ese es como se llama la jaula. Oigan,
sí, es que para ellos sí tienen espacio, ellos sí pueden estar. Oye, aquí
la jaula que nos acaban de poner es la jaula de Donald Trump.
Jail somehow. If they see us around here in this way, they will think that we are doing something bad, because there is a security guard and the police officer right here. So they will think that there is something wrong with us. So let's keep it smiley, relaxed. So they might think, well, they're having fun over there. There is not a problem, okay? So if we keep it down, they're not going to be concerned. They're not going to be scared, because they see a lot of things happening in this community. Very often, we don't want them to feel scared. We don't want them to feel that we are threaters or perpetrators or someone that is trying to do damage to them, okay?
Ya lo dije en español.
Lo dije en español, pero no estaba diciendo en inglés, okay? So lo que dije en español, ya que mantuviéramos el espíritu abajo para que no nos asustara, okay? So, no estamos cautivos, pero ellos van a pensar que sí lo estamos, ¿verdad? Porque estamos encerrados en una jaula. Y técnicamente estamos vigilados por guardias de seguridad que parecen policías, ¿verdad? Entonces cualquiera que vea esto va a pensar que hay algo malo pasando entre nosotros y que nosotros estamos haciendo algún daño.
Queremos que vengan,
visitantes, estamos haciendo algo positivo, y lo positivo es continuar cumpliendo, ¿verdad? Para que la mejor, que no hay tensión, que estamos subiendo y que parece que estamos esperando algo, ¿verdad? Cualquier tema que ustedes pongan en la agenda,
están obligados a responder, porque ya está escrito en la agenda. Los comentarios públicos son solamente para escuchar preocupaciones de la comunidad y no están obligados a contestar. De hecho, si contestan en los comentarios públicos, están violando el acta. Se pueden tener sanción en los votos. So, hay un como 50 y 50 en esa posibilidad.
¿Verdad? Pero entonces, ¿cuál sería la idea de que la gente que de la comunidad venga a opinar o a dar sus preocupaciones y usted, si no va a haber ninguna solución o no va a tomar
en esa forma?
Si lo van a tomar en cuenta y lo van a...
En esa forma podemos escribir y seguir demandando. Podemos escribir y seguir demandando que pongan como tema de la agenda esta preocupación que tenemos, exigir que lo pongan en la agenda para que entonces estén obligados a responder. Porque si seguimos poniéndolo en comentarios públicos, no nos van a... Usando esa regla, no nos van a contestar porque les beneficia a ellos no contestarnos, ¿verdad? En algunos casos, cuando el board quiere trabajar con la comunidad, se ve atado y no trabaja porque lo ponen en comentarios públicos. Pero en esta ocasión, es de beneficio para el board que nosotros hablemos en comentarios públicos porque no están obligados a contestarnos. De hecho, violarían las reglas ellos si nos contestaran. Por eso es importante que sigamos escribiendo, que sigamos llamando, que sigamos presionando para que lo hagan parte de la agenda, obligando también a hacer un discussion meeting. Pueden hacer una junta especial donde solamente se hable de este tema exclusivamente. Y tienen que, si seguimos empujando, podemos organizar un community forum. Podemos demandar a través, a ustedes pueden ir al link de caso. Pueden decir al Consejo de Vecinos que ustedes quieren tener un diálogo con los directores de la escuela TAS. Y el Neighborhood Council es su representante y puede ir y hacer una invitación para que vengan al Community Forum para que hagan un reporte sobre cómo está funcionando la escuela. Y ahí sí están obligados a
I'm holding myself so bad because it's white. And
that's what we were asking. We were asking to have diversity on our board, you know, people that look like us, and, you know, could be able to understand the needs of the
community. Let's all take a picture.
Let's take a picture.
Okay, aquí vaya. Marta.
We do respect the police.
Marta. Una foto aquí.
¿Quién viene acá a tomar una foto con la policía?
Bien, vaya. Nuestros compañeros.
De este lado del poste, si quieres.
Si quieres, aquí, agárrelo, mi amor. Aquí.
¿Y tú a Kitio, no?
Dígale a sus compañeros.
A ver,
¡Cállame!
Así que se vea bien.
Oh,
muchas mujeres que van a trabajar con la comunidad.
Allá nos vamos a ir. Allá nos vamos a ir cerca de nosotros. Acerca de nosotros.
La policía trabaja con nosotros. Esta es nuestra comunidad.
Avancemos allá donde están nosotros.
Ok.
Una, dos y tres.
¡Whisky!
¡No whisky! ¡No whisky! ¡No te faltes! ¡No te
faltes!
¡Al otro! ¡Allá está la otra patrulla!
¡Ya se va! ¡Ya se va!
¡Vamos!
¡No, ya se va! Compañeras, muchas gracias por haber venido. Everyone, thank you so much for coming through. The support that you're giving Hilda is amazing.
Okay.
And I want to make... El apoyo que están dando a nuestra compañera Hilda es increíble. Queremos nosotros asegurar que sigamos marchando y no nos demos por vencidos. La siguiente, ténganlos por seguro que si no se resuelve esto, vamos a tratar este asunto para la siguiente junta de la mesa directiva. Así que estén al tanto de eso. Pero por lo pronto hoy fue un éxito. Queríamos lograr agarrar la atención de ellos y lo logramos. Así que muchas gracias por eso. ¿Se puede?
¡Sí, se puede!
¡Qué bueno! Y así será, compañeras. Muchas gracias.
¡Unidos jamás será vencido!
¡El pueblo
unido 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 jamás será vencido!
¡Qué queremos! ¿Y cuándo?
¡Ahora!
¿Qué queremos?
¡Justicia!
¿Y cuándo?
¡Ahora!
¿El siguiente mes?
¡No!
¿Cuándo?
¡Ahora!
¿En la siguiente semana?
¡No!
¿Cuándo?
¡Ahora!
¿Cuándo?
¡Ahora!
¿Cuándo?
¡Ahora!
¿Cuándo?
¡Ahora!
Gracias, compañeras.
Okay.
Peace out. Vámonos.